outputs in a formatted way. Because in the Fortran programming book of Rajaraman, it is given some, in some of the chapters it is written, if you want to write the outputs in a formatted way, how you should write. You can define the format, like how many decimal points after the, how many digits after the decimal points you'd like to have the data, whether single digits after the decimal or more digits after the decimal, or how many gaps should be there in between each data point, so each variable. So this is like, writing the outputs in a formatted way. So that you should learn by reading the book of the Rajaraman book. Okay. And otherwise also you can write in a free format, like I was showing you yesterday, that if you just write unit number and the file name, and then you just write u comma ij, I is equal to 1 to 10, comma j is equal to 1 to 10, bracket close, bracket close, then it will write in one row. Like various ways to write, so that you don't have to have a lengthy file of 200 lines. You can just have 10 lines only to write all the values, because you have got only 10 grid lines. Are you able to understand what I'm trying to say? Yeah. So it all depends on how you specify
yes,
the right
yes, sir,
statement
yes.
in your program. Okay. So you can specify the right statement in such a way that you write in a pair ways, like u comma v, or you can write all the u's, values of u in one row, then all the values of v in one row. I mean, there are various ways of writing. So you can try that way. That will be a small exercise for all of you. Then the next thing would be, of course, suppose if you have written this value of u and v, okay, and is this u and v just arbitrary value, or you have just tried to pick up the value of u based upon the that wind vector which I drew yesterday, the circulation? How did you pick up?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, like that only.
Like
the
that.
Wind speed increases. Yeah.
Okay.
Tried to. Yeah.
So if you have done that way, then if you plot your output, whatever output you have written, you plot your output using the grads, then it should show you a very nice cyclonic circulation. Do you understand?
Okay,
you
have, sir.
Yeah. If you, okay, right now it is a simple output form you have written, but in order to plot by grads, you have to write in a grads format, right? And if you write in the grads format and then plot the field using the grads, then you should be able to see the cyclonic circulation which I drew by hand roughly yesterday. You get the point?
Yes,
so,
sir.
Yeah, that exercise also will do. Then only you will learn, basically. Otherwise, what you know is, a given data set like ERA and the GRADS program, the ERA data set is already given to you in the GRADS format. Right, there was probably a CTL file also, right? There is a CTL file also given with the ERA data, isn't it? Control file. When you plot the ERA data, have you plotted the ERA data earlier?
Yes, so in grads we have done.
Yes, sir.
Right, so in grads you have done that.
Sir, we don't download the data file, we download the netcdf. We have downloaded netcdf, sir. Only one. One we have worked with CTL file.
So what you work with, netcdf is also a data file only in the netcdf format, isn't it? Netcdf is also a data file in netcdf format. And was there any CTL file also?
So not with the netcdf, but
so
that's why it was saved.
Okay. So when you are just plotting, reading a binary data set and trying to plot using the grads, then you need to have a CTL file. Okay. And that CTL file you can create yourself also. So once you create the CTL file and you have got the binary data set in the grads format, then you can plot the data using the grads and see whether you are able to get the cyclonic circulation or not. That will be exercise. Now, all those things are small exercise, but very good for learning purpose. Right? Then your concept will be clear. If you do that way from the scratch, then your concept will be clear how to write any data set in the GRADS format. And then plot it. right? In whatever output form you want to write, you can write it. You can write it also in the NetCDF format also later on, right? So that's how you will learn. And once you have got confidence, you know, in this, then afterwards, of course, you can further continue the exercise which we have been doing, like compute the divergence and vorticity, right? That is the exercise we started, and all these things have come as part of that, isn't it? So the exercise we wanted to do is to compute the divergence and vorticity, but all these things have come, and then you are trying to learn, right? So now that you have started to learn from the basic, from the scratch, so also learn all these things, like you write the output in the grads format, plot it, and then see whether you are able to see the wind vectors in the cyclic circulation form or not. Once you have done that, that means you are sure that whatever you have extracted the wind speed and wind direction manually from that chart, from that map which I drew by hand, you have picked up the values correctly. If you have not picked up the value correctly, then that means you will not be able to see the cyclic circulation when you plot using the dots file. You understand that? If you have not picked up the values correctly, that means when you plot it back using the grads, then you will not be able to see the cyclic circulation. You will see some circulation, some random circulation you might see, some wind vector you will be able to see, but may not be a very nice cyclic circulation if you have not picked up the value correctly. Because you have got a pair of U and V anyway. So once you have got a pair of U and V, now the grads will plot the wind vector somehow. But that wind vector may or may not be in the cyclonic circulation form, depending upon whether you have picked up the data in a proper way or not. So that will all be a learning process and a very nice test for yourself. Okay. And then as a part of that, you can continue. After that, the next thing you can do is just compute the divergence and plot the divergence also using the grads. Contour of the divergence, you plot using the grads. Then next exercise, compute the vorticity and then plot the vorticity using the grads. See, they are all interrelated, step by step, one by one. You're just trying to learn things and then also marching forward, going ahead. So is that clear what I've been telling you, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so, but I want to make sure that whether I see that definitely Adhikasri is ahead of all of you. She has been able to quickly do the exercise. And many of you are still probably struggling with the program. Some of you are still struggling with the compilation error, some writing problem, reading problem, etc. But I want all of you to come to the level before we go to the next step, right? And in that case, because we want everybody to learn, so the one who has learned faster, like Adhikasri has learned faster, so she will be able to help the others, right? So let me go in sequence. I'll call Adhira. Adhira?
Yes, sir.
So what is the status you have?
Sir, I have downloaded, I have downloaded the data and I was doing, but now my Ubuntu is having some problem. It's not responding. Ubuntu is not responding and it's saying some other process are going on in the background. So I was resolving that.
Okay. So you are struggling with some other thing.
Yesterday, yes, sir.
Yesterday class, you were not there, right?
Yes, sir. I joined, but it got disconnected because there was no power. So my laptop got discharged.
I see. Yesterday, I gave them a new exercise, a very simple exercise to learn from the scratch. Okay.
Yes, sir. I talked to Harita. I got it. I will try it in the weekend.
Okay. So I yesterday's video, I have not been able to download and upload on the YouTube. I'll do that. So you can, all of you, those who missed the class yesterday can see that video of yesterday. Okay, and then do the exercise, because that exercise will teach you from the beginning, the scratch, right?
So, okay, sir. I will complete it by this weekend.
So you do that by this weekend, okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right. The next person I see in the line, Gitesh, yeah, tell me, tumhara kya status, sir?
I told you I was with Harita only. same problem I solved it. That the number of rows, the number of rows in input is equal to the number of rows of output I'm getting. So I'm just changing the input data again. I'm putting 100 input data in a single row, a single column. Sorry.
So ठीक है. So now next thing you should try, as I said, is that how to write it in a formatted way rather than writing everything in one column.
Sir, I'm getting two rows. Yeah, one for you a separate column and for we a separate. One minute, let me show you.
So that means you are writing all the 100 values of you in one row, and then all the 100 values of me. You say no, I did not tell you that way. I told you to write say 10 pairs of you v in one row, then 10 pairs of you v in the next row, and so on. As if you are going from south to north. Right, or north to south. You think that your domain is like in a real domain covering some part of, you know, say, you know, map of India, whether it is covering Delhi or Rajasthan or whatever, and you are computing the divergence or vorticity from north to south or south to north. So you write the pair of UV, okay, and since you have only 10 points in one row, so write 10 pairs of UV in one row. 10 pairs of UV in second row, and go on like that. So that will be your second exercise, right?
Okay.
So then Sayoni, so what is your status, Sayoni?
Sir, I have a problem with my laptop. My laptop is not switching on only. So yes, I gave it for repairing. I don't know whether I'll be able to do it till next practical class, because they are going to give it me back till Wednesday or Thursday.
But I
talked to Harita about yesterday's class, and I tried doing that. I mean, I was I drew the grid points and I was trying to do it.
But how will you do unless you have a laptop? How can you do that?
So I can do, I don't have my own laptop, but I have my father's laptop. That there I can do just the Excel. In Excel I can write, and I can just make the text file. Not, I can't run the code, but I can just only.
Yeah, you can't. You don't have the Linux loaded.
No, sir.
Right.
I don't have the Linux.
Yeah, and don't try to, otherwise you will mess up your father's laptop. And yes.
Yes, sir.
So try to get your laptop, you know, repaired as soon as possible.
Yes,
and then,
sir.
Then you can do that. So anyway, all these things are getting recorded and upload the video. So whatever you missed, you know, you just watch the video and do all those exercises. You know,
yes, sir.
Not from the beginning. So next I ask Shubham. Shubham?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So what is your status? Tell me.
सर मेरा लैपटॉप भी सर स्विच ऑफ ये सर ऑन नहीं हो रहा है सुबह से सुबह सर कल नहीं सर कल शाम को आपका फोटन प्रोग्राम बना रहा था सडनली स्विच ऑफ हो गया और मैं डिस्कनेक्ट भी हो गया था कल और ऑन नहीं हुआ उसके बाद लेकिन आज सुबह फिर ऑन किया ऑन हुआ लेकिन एक दो घंटे के बाद फिर वो स्विच ऑफ हो गया अपने आप और तभी से सर ओपन नहीं
यू आल्सो हैव द सेम प्रॉब्लम लैपटॉप प्रॉब्लम दैट मींस यू आल्सो हैव टू गेट इट रिपेयर्ड
यस
अदरवाइज यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू डू द प्रैक्टिकल राइट और पता नहीं तुम कहां पे किस जगह पे हो उस शहर में लैपटॉप का रिपेयरिंग होता भी है कि नहीं होता है
सर रिपेयरिंग तो होता है पर सर सैटरडे और संडे हमारा यहां शट डाउन रहता है सर
अच्छा कहां पे व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ द प्लेस योर
सर झारसुगुड़ा ब्रजराज नगर
दर्शकदा वहां पे है लैपटॉप रिपेयरिंग का शॉप वगैरह
हां सर है
हां कहीं बिगाड़ ना दे तुम्हारा लैपटॉप को बनाने के बदले में कहीं उल्टा बिगाड़ ना दे सो देख लेना बट एनीवे लैपटॉप इज अ मस्ट ब्राउज का तो काम ही नहीं होगा
यस देन
नजमीन कैन यू हियर मी नजमीन आर यू एबल टू हियर मी मेरी आवाज आ रही है नजमीन She is not hearing me. So problem होता है हमेशा network का. Okay, Asna, can you hear me? Asna, are you able to hear me? आवाज तुम्हारी नहीं आ रही है. Can you switch on your video and audio also? I don't know whether audio is on or not. Audio तुम्हारा on लग रहा है. I don't know. Asna, can you hear me? Asna? Policy is not hearing me. Who is the next person? Next person, who is this? Next, maybe Anish. Anish, can you hear me? Anish, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
बताओ वीडियो को ऑन करो और बताओ क्या क्या कर रहे हो तुम्हारा हुआ कि नहीं हुआ ये एक्सरसाइज सो व्हाट इज द स्टेटस
सर मैंने प्रोग्राम लिख लिया उसके बाद जैसे रन किया है हरिता ने और हरिता का जो प्रॉब्लम आ रहा है रो वाला प्रॉब्लम सर सेम प्रॉब्लम मेरा भी आ रहा है सर
नहीं उसका प्रॉब्लम तो नहीं आ रहा उसने तो लिखा सिर्फ कॉलम है इसलिए कॉलम हो गया Now you have to do
हाँ सर लेकिन सर वो पहले जो प्रॉब्लम हो रहा था ना कि रो को वो रीड नहीं करता था वो आपने जैसे बोला था मैट्रिक्स के फॉर्म में बनाने के लिए जैसे सर मैंने भी बनाया था 3x3 की मैट्रिक्स को तो उस तरीके से सर वो रीड नहीं कर पा रहा और उस तरीके से अगर करके जब मैं आउटपुट ले यस सर जब आउटपुट आ रहा है सर लेकिन 20 आउटपुट ही आ रहे हैं सर
तो देयर इज सम प्रॉब्लम रीडिंग तो कर लिया उसने आफ्टर हैविंग रीड द डेटा देन सी हैज रिटन इन ए सिंगल कॉलम ऑल द 200 वैल्यूज राइट तो रीडिंग तो अब कोई बात नहीं रीडिंग तो जैसे भी तुमने कर लिया अब द नेक्स्ट टास्क इज हाउ टू राइट इन द फॉर्मेट इन व्हिच यू वांटेड तुम जिस फॉर्मेट में चाहते हो उस फॉर्मेट में लिखना कैसे है रीडिंग तो तुमने जैसे भी कर लिया मान लो व्हाट एवर यू रीड ना रीडिंग तुमने कर लिया एंड मैनुअली एक्सट्रैक्ट किया होगा डेटा
सर
हाँ
बट जो इनपुट फाइल है उस इनपुट फाइल के अंदर जो हमने डाटा डाला है वो डाटा किस पैटर्न में अरेंज कर रहे हैं उसको वो भी तो मैटर करता है ना सर कि आउटपुट कैसा मिलेगा
हाँ तो आउटपुट तो तुम जिस तरह से लिखोगे राइट वाला जो स्टेटमेंट है उस राइट स्टेटमेंट में तुम जिस तरह से लिखोगे उसी तरह से वो लिखेगा फाइल में तुम कहोगे कि सिंगल कॉलम में लिख दो तो सारा डेटा सिंगल कॉलम में लिख देगा तुम कहोगे कि पेयर में लिखो और एक रो में 10 वैल्यू लिखो तो उस तरह से लिखेगा तुम जिस तरह से स्टेटमेंट दोगे फॉर्मेट उस तरह से लिखेगा वो उसके लिए तुमको पढ़ना पड़ेगा हाउ टू फॉर्मेट द डेटा फ्रॉम दैट बुक राइट एंड आई जस्ट गिव यू वन एग्जाम्पल यस्टरडे यू माइट हैव सीन दैट लाइक आई सेड राइट यू In bracket ij, comma, I is equal to 1 to 10, bracket close, j is equal to 1 to 10. तो उसमें का मतलब है कि और एक रो में 10 वैल्यू लिखेगा पहले उसके बाद फिर नेक्स्ट 10 वैल्यू लिखेगा राइट तो इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन हाउ यू स्पेसिफाई द फॉर्मेट टू राइट दिस इज ऑल्सो द वे टू लर्न हाउ टू राइट द डेटा इन द डिजायर्ड फॉर्मेट ओके कल को तुमको सूसी डेटा को ग्राफ्स के फॉर्मेट में लिखना पड़ेगा You want to plot by grads, you have to write the same data in the grads format. Right. So therefore, you must be very, very comfortable and confident in writing the output in the desired format. समझ रहे हो? तो इसको तुम देखो कि कैसे करेंगे and then if you have doubt, then ask Gitesh or Harita, Sri, and then do the exercise. If you want to show something. On the screen, no, you can share. Otherwise, you can do the exercise and show me next time. Okay.
Yes, sir, actually, I'm with phone, sir. Now.
You're getting phone call. Hello.
No, sir. Sir, मैं अभी हाँ sir अभी मैं phone से on कर रखा है मैंने laptop से नहीं है sir.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I see. I'm not. Oh, अच्छा अच्छा. Screen share नहीं. क्यों क्या laptop में laptop पे charge नहीं है क्या charge नहीं है क्या काम नहीं कर रहा.
सर एक्चुअली नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम है और जो मेरा डाटा वो पूरा खत्म हो चुका है तो लैपटॉप से प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है सर यस सर
ओके दीज आर द प्रैक्टिकल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ ऑनलाइन क्लासेस तो चलो कोई बात नहीं तो बैकग्राउंड में तो अपना एक्सरसाइज कर लेना जब भी तुम्हारा जब नेटवर्क आएगा पावर आएगा तो अपना लैपटॉप पे कर लेना फिर अगली क्लास में तुमसे बात करेंगे ओके
हेलो सर
Yes, Asna, I was calling you.
Sir, I was having some problem with my earphones, so I changed them.
So, are you on the laptop or on the mobile?
Laptop, sir, laptop.
So, okay, switch on your video and tell me what is the status of your work.
Yes, sir, sure. Sir, is it visible? So yesterday I tried using a table to get the output in the proper format, like one column for direction, one column for speed, and one column for U and V. So, but the same, it was showing error in the input. Now I know why, because we have to write everything in single column. It was showing that end of the program or the end of the file, something like this error.
So reading file itself had a problem.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so reading करने के बाद when you write the output, then you should be able to write the output the way you want it, right? Not in single column, but in.
Sir, the output way. Yes, sir. The output I am getting the headings which I give, the header of the table like the X, Y, U, V. That I am getting in the output, but not the values.
Yeah, so you write the X, Y, you can write 10 values of U, V, pair U, V in one row, and then next row, and then next row like that.
All yes.
The right, so you can write in that format. And how to write that format, if you want to learn, then it is given in that book, Bazar Aman Ka Kitab Mein Diya Hua.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. Right.
So, fine. So, since I'm glad that at least two of the students are able to read the file and write it in some format at least, whether it is in one column or more. So, but once you have done it in one column, you can write in whatever format you want it. So, that is no problem. Uske baad ye kaun hai? Najmin, are you back? Najmin, are you there? So, you're still having a problem. Najmin? Yeah, tumhara kya status hai? Tumhara laptop theek hua ki nahi hua? Video ko on karo. Switch on your video.
Yes, sir.
बाकी लोग कहाँ चले गए? Only 8 people I can see. Even 4 are not there. Yes. So what is the status? Laptop tumhara kaam kar raha hai?
Yes sir, lekin sir is jo Ubuntu wala laptop hai sir usme main connect nahi ho pa rahi hu class se.
Kya nahi ho rahi hai?
Sir connect nahi ho pa rahi hu sir class se. Class mein connect nahi ho pa rahi hu sir Ubuntu wala laptop se.
Main samajh nahi aa raha. Awaaz clear nahi ho raha tumhara. लैपटॉप पे तुम्हारा लिनक्स लोडेड है फोर्ट्रान लोडेड है
यस सर
सो कैन यू शेयर योर स्क्रीन ऐसे करके नहीं प्रेजेंट वो तो तुम वीडियो में दिखा रहे हो अच्छा तुम्हारा अलग अलग लैपटॉप है क्या एक लैपटॉप बात करने के लिए एक लैपटॉप काम करने के लिए ऐसा है क्या तुम्हारा
नहीं सर ये दरअसल सर उसकी जो मेरा ये जो लैपटॉप मिले हुए सर ये गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से मिले हुए हैं
इसमें तो कुछ हम पढ़ नहीं सकते आई कैन नॉट रीड नोबडी कैन रीड इन दिस वे फ्रॉम योर स्क्रीन अनलेस यू शेयर द स्क्रीन उसको एक ही लैपटॉप पे होना
पड़ेगा सर वो सर उसने बोला कि जो उसका लिनक्स वाला लैपटॉप है ना सर उससे वो गूगल मीट से क्लास अटेंड नहीं कर पा रही है वो ये बोल रही है सर
आई सी
उसको प्रॉब्लम हो रही है उसमें
तो देन आई वी कैन नॉट सी योर स्क्रीन इन दैट केस हम लोग तुम्हारा स्क्रीन देख नहीं पाएंगे इस तरह से नो वी कैन नॉट सी योर स्क्रीन ओके
कोशिश करती हूं अगर हो जाती तो मैं ट्राई करूंगी इसमें कुछ प्रॉब्लम होगा
ट्राई करो अभी तुम्हारा दोनों अलग-अलग लैपटॉप है एक लैपटॉप से तुम बात कर रहे हो दूसरा लैपटॉप से तुम काम कर रहे हो तो एनीवे यू नो जो मैंने कहा है यू हैव अंडरस्टूड व्हाट आई हैव सेड
यस सर यस सर
ओके तो उस एक्सरसाइज को करने की कोशिश करो एंड देन Then if you have doubt, then ask Haritasri or Gitesh. Okay, those who have done the exercise
successfully.
Okay, so fine. Bas 8 hi log hain, baaki log kahan hain? Where are the others? Okay, Shweta kahan hai? Rahul chala gaya again. Rahul is offline, is it?
Sir, Shweta can't join. Her father is hospitalized.
Oh God. God, yes, good.
Sir, nothing serious, just the platelet count decreased.
So, yes. So, will not be able to join today. Rahul ko kya ho gaya?
Sir, Rahul's network died.
So, his network is died, okay. So, theek hai, who he left? Vibhuti was there earlier, but now he's not there. Vibhuti ko kya ho gaya? So, ठीक है, all those of you who are here, you have heard, you know, what is to be done next, right? Aritasri?
Yes, sir.
Next task is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good, very good. So, try to do those things now in the weekend and then we will see. We are just trying to do the exercise step by step in a very simple way, right? Like plotting the output in a desired way. Writing the output in the grads format, plotting the output using the grads, trying to verify whether your wind percolation is throwing a cyclone or not. All those things are nice exercise, simple exercise, which will clear your concept and help you in understanding clearly. And then the next step, you compute the divergence and plot the divergence contours. You plot the shading is also, you must have learned how to share the data, that you can also try compute the vorticity, share the data. So after you have computed the divergence and vorticity, then we will move on to the next exercise for integration. All these things are horizontal differentiation using the numerical method finite difference. After this, we will do the exercise for numerical integration. And for that exercise, we will compute the vertical velocity. Okay. So one by one, we will try to do all those things.
Okay, sir.
So, fine. So, for today, I think we stop, or do we have any other things to discuss? Any other points to discuss today?
So, that's all for today.
Okay, very good. So, thank you. It's already 4:30, 5:30 now. So, we stop for today and then we'll meet for our regular class on Monday. Okay?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
And then the weekend also you try to do all the exercise. Those of you who have not done, you complete that. And those of you who have done today's exercise, do the next part which I have just explained to you today. Alright?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes, sir.
Yeah. Finally. Good night. Yeah. Thank you. Good night. All the best. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye.